I've earned the platinum trophies for the entire Crash Bandicoot and Sane Trilogy, and made videos on each of them, but I don't have 100% completion of the trilogy. And that is because there are two DLC levels I still need to complete and earn the trophies for, beginning with Stormy Ascent. This level is notoriously difficult, and Naughty Dog removed it from the original Crash Bandicoot game because it was too difficult, and I'm about to find out why.
I didn't make that?
Nope.
The first trophy we're chasing is simple. It says to seek and destroy, which just means to complete the level and break all boxes. This isn't too bad because of several checkpoints on the level. Real challenge will come soon. This level is difficult because of several tricky jumps, including stairs that disappear every few seconds.
Why did the stairs take so long to come out?
Here's one of the tricky jumps I was talking about. I was literally shook while playing this level that I died on simple jumps like this one.
Bro.
And like this one.
I died.
Oh, that takes me so far back. I felt the biggest sense of relief after finally making that jump.
Oh my goodness, I made it. Finally.
The bonus level then served as a checkpoint, and the puzzle in here really wasn't too hard to solve. But honestly, we quickly go back to dying after these platforms that disappear pretty quickly and these stairs that disappear pretty quickly.
Bro.
Oh, and don't forget about the spikes that are next to these platforms.
What?
These bird jumps are the end of the level, which gives us our first trophy.
Oh, I made it. Thank goodness. Those are the last six boxes. I can't mess this up. We got it. We got it. That should be a trophy.
The crown jewel. There we go. Up next was the hardest trophy of both DLCs, and that was the time trial on Stormy Ascent. I know some people are going to think that this isn't tough because Crash 4 requires platinum relics and this game only requires gold, but believe me, it was tough simply because of how lengthy this level is.
Why did I jump so early, bro?
And dying 1 or 2 minutes into the time trial was the absolute worst.
I overjumped. You can't make it back up. Oh,
this one jump in particular almost made me rage quit.
Wow.
After several more tries, I finally made it.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
By this point, I was just out of it because this next clip is kind of ridiculous.
Hey yo, what the?
I swear I wasn't trolling there. I was just dead tired by this point, but I did eventually get the jump. This next death right here is what made me call it quits for the night.
No!
After sleeping on it, I actually completed the run pretty quickly on my second attempt the very next day. And that gets us our trophy.
Oh, I did it! I did it! Gold! There we go, we did it. Oh my goodness, it's the next day now. We did it. That level is the hardest level in the game. I don't want to hear otherwise.
And now we're off to future tense in Crash 3.
So of course there's boxes right in the beginning. I had to check.
The first trophy here is to seek and destroy again. The cool thing about this level is it's the first original Crash Bandicoot level in over 20 years and the only original level in the Insane Trilogy.
Bro, what? How did that even kill me?
I know I just showed myself dying, but believe me, this level was so much easier than Stormy Ascent. I pretty much used my bazooka whenever possible, cleared the death route pretty swiftly, and got the gem there.
Our gem.
Then ran through the level using the checkpoints and breaking all the boxes. Pretty soon, we got our second to last trophy.
We did it! Trophy incoming. Future is clear. Now we just need to beat the time trial. Get gold or better, and then that's it. That's the DLC trophy.
Bruh.
So the last trophy of the entire trilogy isn't actually a time trial, but I did not look this up beforehand and attempted the time trial thinking I had to. I was aiming for gold or better, and this was the result after a few minutes.
And I did it. That's gotta be gold. Maybe platinum. That's Sapphire, bro.
Are we serious? Now, I would like to be able to tell you I looked up the trophy at this point, but I didn't. I jumped right back into the time trial to go for gold because I knew I could do it. I didn't need to, but I didn't know that. After a few more attempts, I got the gold relic I was seeking, and then it finally hit me.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, that's it. I did it.
Wow.
That was a little more difficult than I thought. Still easier than Stormy Ascent. It's just Stormy Ascent is different with the timing of the jumps, but that should give us our trophy. And that means I'm 100% in Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy. The trophy didn't pop yet though. Come on. So apparently there's no time trial trophy in this level. You just have to shoot a UFO. I didn't know that. To him. And that's it. That's our trophy. I thought it was a time trial trophy, but it's that.